In this video, I want to show you how to create the new Google Ads demand gen campaign recently rolled out by Google. And this is basically an upgraded discovery campaign, or you can say demand gen is a new formation of discovery ads. Let's go ahead and see how we can set up a demand gen campaign. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalam-o-alikuM. This is Sayyida Azra from amfahhtech YouTube channel, where you find all about technology. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create demand gen campaign so that you can profit and maximize the growth of your channel and business. Demand gen campaign help business to reach consumers with over 3 billion monthly users on Google on placements like YouTube Shorts, YouTube InStreams, YouTube Feeds, Discover and Gmail. We can use demand gen to run ads across YouTube platforms, Google Discover and Gmail. These are going to be really, really appealing ads, as these platforms get a lot of traffic on a regular basis, so you will be able to reach out to a huge number of customers and viewers through this particular campaign. Before we start, if you didn't subscribe my channel yet, then subscribe it right now and hit the bell icon so that you will be notified whenever I drop a new video. One more important point here, that I also create videos on the request of my viewers and subscribers. So if you want me to create video on any topic, just write me in the comment section. I'll definitely make video for you. Now let's go ahead and see how to create demand gen campaign in Google Ads. First thing you need to do is sign into your Google Ads account. If you don't know how to create and log in Google Ads account, watch out my this video. The link of this video you will find in the description on I button and end screen. Once done, click right here on new campaign. So first thing you see here is campaign objective. You can select any of these options that work for you, and that is your objective or goal. You can choose sales, leads or ad promotion, but I'm gonna click create a campaign without goal guidance. So then we need to select campaign type. And this time we're gonna select demand gen campaign over here. Here we still have to ensure that you have convenient actions, convenient goals implemented in this campaign, as this is our first demand gen campaign, so no such convenient goal is here. If you want, you can add goal here. For now, going to go ahead and click continue here. And now we can start building out our campaign. There's not a lot of steps that we are going to get through. So now let's start and see how to set up properly. Start with campaign name, and I'm gonna type here discovery ad. So here you would set your goal. Campaign goal can be convenience, clicks or convenient value. Convenience. Here you can get more sales and other actions with your audience. This means you have conversion tracking set. Google will show you ads to people who are most likely to convert. Next is clicks. Here you can get more traffic and clicks using cost per click strategy, which means that Google will focus on getting as many clicks as possible. Conversion value. In this case, we don't have this available. Let's go with the clicks here. Alright, next budget and dates. So over here you can set budget. First, let's start the start and end date for this campaign and then decide daily budget. For end date, let's choose 30th April. Now for budget, let's suppose I want to spend 10,000 per day. See here, Google recommendation. You don't have to do all the Google recommendations. Do whatever you are comfortable with. For demo purpose, I'm gonna choose, let's say, 15,000 as daily budget. Now you have location and language settings. Demand gen campaign works a little bit differently from the display and YouTube search campaign. In this campaign type, your ad groups are like different campaigns, because that's where you would be able to set your different locations and languages for each ad group. See, it says we recommend setting locations and languages at ad group level. By default, this location and language setting is at ad group level. So either you can keep it to ad group level, or if you want location and language at campaign level, you can switch this option on. Once you turn it on, then your location and language setting is at campaign level. And you can come in here for location settings, choose enter another location, enter location, and search for, let's say, Pakistan. India, United States, United Kingdom, Canada, and Australia. Then we scroll down and select the languages like English, Hindi, Punjabi, and Urdu. Down here, you can also set devices. Let's say we don't want TV screen, so uncheck it. Moving down, set ad schedule here. You can set your ad to run on any specific day and time. I want to keep all day 24/7. Next is campaign URL option. If you have some sort of third-party tracking integration setup, you can use this setting. Leave it blank. Okay, now let's move forward to the ad group level now. This is ad group tab. We will do ad group settings here. And we can name our ad group here. For now, keep it same. Then we are gonna create audience. Audience allow you to reach people based on who they are, their interest, habits, and what they are researching. So over here, you can create an audience. As we don't have any saved audience, so we're gonna create new. Give a name to your audience. Let's say I'm giving a demo audience. Here in this part, we can add all types of audience targeting like affinity audience, custom audience, lookalike audience. So let's have a look at these campaigns. You can set here different types of people you want to target. First is custom segments. You can create custom audience from here, or if you have any already created audience, you can attach them from here. Right now, we don't have any, so I'm gonna create new audience. So over here, click on new segments. Give a name to this custom segment. For demo purpose, I'm giving demo segment. Moving down, choose people with their interest and behavior. I will go with people that search for specific terms and add search term ideas for this segment. You can add different search ideas that people will search. Okay, that would be enough for now. Hit save. See here, one segment has been created. Currently, this is under review, but soon we'll get approval. Next is your data. Your data is going to be remarketing audience. If you have been any remarketing audience that you have been using in the past that interacted with your business, or if you want to create new with this campaign, you can do that as well. Lookalike audience. Lookalike audience is also another audience type which Google brought back for demand gen campaign. Here you can set a local lookalike audience that is similar to the Facebook audience. And in the last, if you don't want any of these, you can select specific audiences. So that you can come in here. You can select people based on their interest and demographics. As in my case, I'm promoting my tech channel, so I'm gonna target people interested in technology. social media enthusiasts, advertising and media service, we can also add exclusions. For example, you can say, I don't want people from your customer list or YouTube users, then you can exclude them from here. Here in demographics, we can target specific genders and specific ages. So let's suppose I want to target people from 18 to 54 years old, knowing my YouTube audience. Once done, click on save. So that is, audience is created. You can also edit this by clicking on this pencil icon. Next, you have optimized targeting. If you select this option, then Google Ads will show you ads to people that are similar to what you are selected here. So leave it off for now. So these are all audience targeting options which we get in demand gen campaign. Once you fill this up, then we are moving to the next segment, which is ad creation part. Hit go to ad 1. This is where ad creation takes place. Firstly, let's give name to this ad. I'm gonna name it as ad 1 discovery. So moving up here, Google gives you different types of ads to create. Single image ad, it's just going to single image display ad. A video ad, this will show ads with single video ad. A carousel image, which can have multiple images in it. Let's say we are doing single image ad, select it. Down here is media section. Here you need to upload images, then text and URL. For images, click add. Here you see different options, including free stock of images to use in your ad. I'm gonna upload images from my desktop. Hit upload, browse and select images. Click open. Images are being uploaded. Okay, done. Click on save. You can also edit images from here. Next is logos. Click add. Upload logo. Browse and select. Hit open. You can adjust the ratio of your logo according to the frame. Hit save. Click on save. Then over here you can add headlines. You can add up to 5 headlines. I want some text for my channel as I'm promoting my channel in this campaign. Copy. And paste it here. You have a limit of 40 characters here. Then over here you will be able to see what is going to look like. Then you have description right here. Copy and paste here. Let's rephrase it to keep in the limit. You can also add more description if you want. You can add up to 5 descriptions. Moving down, you can include call to action. Let's say for my channel, I'm gonna choose subscribe. Type business name here. My business name is amfahhtech. Now, Also, you can enter your URL, so where you want to ultimately take people to go. It's going to be my channel URL where I want my people to land. Copy URL. Paste over here as final URL. So next here, you can create more new ads under this ad group. But I'm going to go to review. This is review campaign page. Make sure everything here is fine. You have everything as you want it to be. And then click on publish campaign. Publishing the campaign would mean that this campaign will go for checking. Now see here, your campaign has been created successfully and is under review. This is my ad group with status pending. Let me quickly show you how to access it. So this is ad group right here that we have just created. We have created one ad group. Click on ads. This is our demand gen campaign that we have just created, which has one ad group in it. And this ad group has only one ad, which is under review. If you want to change campaign settings, you can go here on this icon and you can change settings over here. Once the ad is approved, which takes like one business day or two, then your campaign will go live. So that's it. That's how you can create demand gen campaign. I hope you find this video very effective. If you did, like, subscribe and share. And hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I drop a new video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.